JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for April the 15th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against the majority of the other G10 currencies on Wednesday and during the Asian session Thursday. It underperformed the most versus NZD, NOK and AUD in that order, while it decked out some gains only against the Swiss franc. The greenback was found virtually unchanged versus the British pound and the Japanese yen. Now, the weakening of the US dollar, the Swiss franc and the Japanese yen, combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Kiwi and Aussie, suggests that markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that most major EU indices rose, perhaps on upbeat earnings from software firm SAP and the French luxury goods maker LVMH. The exceptions were Italy's FTSE MIB and the German DAX, with the latter losing 0.17% after sources said that the nation's economic institutes will cut their joint 2021 growth forecasts to 3.7% from 4.7% due to a longer than expected COVID-related lockdown. Now, later in the day in Wall Street, Dow Jones gained 0.16%, hitting a new all-time high, but the S&P 500 and the Nasdaq Composite fell 0.41% and 0.99% respectively, although the former also hit a fresh record before pulling back. This happened despite stellar results from big banks on the first day of the earnings season. The tech sector was the biggest underperformer, perhaps after Coinbase fell nearly 20% on its listing day. Asian shares were on the mixed side, both Nikkei 225 and South Korea's KOSPI traded in the green, while China's Shanghai Composite and Hong Kong's Hang Seng slid. Today, market participants may turn their gaze on the US retail sales for March. Both headline and core sales are forecast to have rebounded 5.9% and 5% month over month respectively, after tumbling 3.5% and 2.7%. This is likely to add more credence to the view that the world's largest economy is recovering from the coronavirus pandemic at a fast pace, and it is unlikely to revive inflation fears. After all, investors were not concerned at all after the headline CPI rate surged to 2.6% year over year in March, which means that they may have accepted the Fed's view that any spike in inflation this year is likely to prove to be temporary. With the committee also holding the view that it is too early to start discussing policy normalization, we believe that equities and other risk-linked assets may respond positively to the retail sales data. On the contrary, the safe havens franc and yen may come under selling interest. As for the US dollar, it may instantly gain, but due to the Fed's commitment to hold its policy extra loose for long, we would expect it to resume its recent slide. Now, as for the rest of today's events, during the European morning, we get Germany's final CPIs for March, but as it is always the case, they are expected to confirm their preliminary estimates. Later in the day, from the US, apart from the retail sales, we also have the initial jobless claims for last week, the New York Empire State Manufacturing Index for April, and the industrial production for March. Initial jobless claims are forecast to have declined to 700,000 from 740,000, While the New York index is anticipated to rise to 19.5 from 17.4. Industrial production is expected to rebound 2.8% month over month after sliding 2.2%. All this data will support the notion of a strong economic recovery in the US and may enhance the aforementioned market reactions. As for tonight, during the Asian session Friday, we get China's GDP for the first quarter, as well as the nation's industrial production, fixed asset investment, and retail sales, all for March. GDP is expected to have slowed to 1.5% quarter over quarter from 2.6%. Industrial production, fixed asset investment, and retail sales are all expected to slow as well. Having said that, though, all prints are expected to stay on the strong side, with the year-over-year GDP rate anticipated to climb above 10% for the first time in a decade. Specifically, it is expected to jump to 18.9% from 6.5%, inflated by the coronavirus-related crash in the year-ago period. Data supporting that the world's second largest economy has recovered from the coronavirus-related damages and is now performing very well may allow market participants to increase their risk exposure. As for the speakers, we have three on today's agenda, and those are Atlanta Fed President Rafael Bostic, San Francisco Fed President Mary Daly, and Cleveland Fed President Loretta Mester. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.